Which type of power production is king in Factorio? Let's dive into the three ways to produce energy and determine the winner. First, there's steam engine power, turning fuel into steam and eventually steam into electricity. Solar panels to harvest radiation from your nearest star, and accumulators to store this energy to get through the night. And finally, nuclear power, unlocking the weak force, one of the fundamental forces of nature, through nuclear fission. Let's compare and determine the pros and cons of each energy source in six categories. For all calculations, I assume a production of 1 gigawatt of energy.
Wait, 21 gigawatts!
How easy is it to set up production and how many materials are required to build a 1 gigawatt energy source? Steam engine power is easy to build. Provide water to a boiler and add 2 steam engines. Supply fuel like coal and you're done. You need 555 boilers and 1100 steam engines and 28 offshore pumps. Each offshore water pump can supply 20 boilers. Total build materials needed, 37,000 iron and 2,800 stone. But I didn't take fuel supply into account. Solar energy is the easiest build of them all. Just build panels and accumulators and put them wherever you want. A ratio of 21 accumulators for each 25 panels is perfect. To reach 1 gigawatt solar power, we need 23,800 panels and 20,000 accumulators. That's a total of 1.13 million iron and 0.75 million copper. Wow. This is still a pro because you can incrementally build solar energy as your factory is growing. You don't have to build it all at once. Nuclear energy, on the other hand, is complicated. Some players struggle to set up a proper nuclear power plant. Time for me to make a dedicated guide, I guess. This power plant with 8 reactors produces 1.12 gigawatts of energy, and I use it as a reference. 72,000 iron and 48,000 copper to build this setup. Not counting other materials and pipes. Way less than solar energy, but more than steam. In order to generate nuclear energy, you also need production of nuclear fuel cells, which can be a struggle too. Steam engines and boilers need a total supply of 15,000 coal per minute. That's 17 yellow bells of coal or 6 express bells. Way too much, if you ask me. Solar energy doesn't need any fuel whatsoever. The reference reactor requires 2.4 uranium fuel cells per minute. With a proper Kovarec setup, you only have to mine 530 uranium per minute, that's half a yellow belt. Consumption of space. To compare the space occupied, I measure space consumption in chunks. A chunk in Factorio is an area 32 times 32 tiles in size. Boilers and steam engines fit into 28 chunks. Solar energy, on the other hand, needs at least 280 to 300 chunks. My reference reactor fits into roughly 6 chunks and is therefore the winner in this category. Pollution is an important factor when playing with biters, especially in a death world. It depends on your game settings if pollution is a concern to you. Steam engine power creates 16,650 pollution per minute. Mining 17 yellow belts full of coal, not included. Solar energy creates no pollution whatsoever. A nuclear power plant emits zero pollution, but the production of fuel cells does. It's a minimal amount though. UPS means updates per second and measures how many update steps or ticks your computer can calculate. Unless your base grows into megabase territory, you don't have to worry about UPS. So for most players, this isn't relevant. Boilers and steam engines are terrible for UPS because the game needs to calculate fluid dynamics. Additionally, 17 belts of coal need to be mined and transported. This usually involves belts, balancers, inserters and most likely trains, which need to be calculated by the game. Solar energy is a clear winner in this category. No entities change and the game doesn't need to calculate anything other than total energy output, depending on the time of day. Nuclear power plants are terrible for UPS. Update steps need to calculate fluid mechanics, spreading the heat in heat pipes and the entire production chain to create fuel. How reliable is each energy source? Steam engine power is unreliable because of its fuel dependency. If production or transportation of coal breaks down, your base will lose power. This can lead to a brown or blackout. Solar energy is very reliable as long as the amount of installed solar panels and accumulators matches your base's demand. If not, you will blackout during nights. Nuclear energy is very reliable as long as your nuclear power plant is built well. Mistakes can unfortunately happen, so I rank this lower than solar energy. Overview and recommendations. Steam engine power only wins in the build difficulty category. It's the best and only choice for very small bases up until the player has access to solar energy. Mid to end game, I recommend getting rid of steam engines. Solar energy is a power production king in Factorio. Solar is best when it comes to pollution, UPS, and how easy it is to just blueprint a chunk of solar energy and copy it all over the map. I highly recommend letting bots build your solar energy farms. If you keep an eye on energy consumption and accumulator charges during nights to prevent blackouts, the only downside is the huge amount of space needed to build thousands of panels and accumulators. Finally, nuclear energy. I love nuclear energy in Factorio. If you know what you're doing and you watch my future nuclear energy guide, the only downside is UPS if building a mega base. I recommend and trust in solar energy, but come on, be a nerd and build at least one proper nuclear power plant in every base.